Disney and Lucasfilm. Hi, I am a shareholder in the Disney company. I am a DVC owner. I'm an annual pass holder. So I've spent a lot of money with you guys. And as you can see, I've invested a lot of money in Lucasfilm products over the years as well. Particularly the storytelling devices, the books. Particularly the expanded universe. I remember my first foray into the expanded universe using my money from my 9th birthday to buy a copy of Han Solo at Star's End in paperback at the bookstore. When this book came out, Heir to the Empire, I didn't just buy it the day it came out. Oh no, I bought 2 copies, one of which I wrapped in cellophane, as you can see. Actually, it's Mylar, and never read this copy. It's never been opened. It is brand new. The pride and joy of my Star Wars collection. I got out of the toys a long time ago, never did the models, was never good at them. I got never big on the tchotchkes. I was big on the storytelling, and I was big on how that universe fit together like giant pieces of a puzzle. My pride and joy has been the last several decades I have spent assembling this. This is one bookshelf that has every Star Wars paperback in chronological order per the expanded universe. Let me give you a physical demonstration of what you just did when you made your announcement Friday that we all knew was coming, that the EU was being trashed. It goes something like this. Oh, let's take episode 1. Set it there. Episode 2, set it there. These over here for safekeeping because we've got more stuff to throw on the ground. But wait, there's more because the shelf is 3 rows deep because it's the entire expanded universe in complete chronological order. Splinter of the Mind's Eye. Oh, gotta go. Even Shadows of the Empire has to go. Yep, all of it. None of it means anything anymore. None of it. Gone. See ya. Toast. That's what you just did. And that's what you've left behind. Any questions?